हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। इफ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब टिल नाउ, प्लीज डू इट। इट विल नॉट टेक टू मच टाइम। ओके, सब्सक्राइब इट, लाइक इट एंड शेयर इट। टुडेज टॉपिक इज एनर्जी। व्हाट एनर्जी? बिफोर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एनर्जी, लेट मी डिस्कस अबाउट वर्क फर्स्ट, बिकॉज वर्क एंड एनर्जी बोथ आर रिलेटेड टू इच अदर। वर्क एंड एनर्जी बोथ आर व्हाट? रिलेटेड टू इच अदर। व्हाट इज वर्क? व्हेन वर्क इज सेड टू बी डन एंड व्हाट इज वर्क? फर्स्ट, व्हेन वर्क इज सेड टू बी डन। Work is said to be done when a force is applied on a body and the body moves. Then only work is said to be done. If the body is not in motion, if the body is not moving, then we cannot say work is done. Clear? So work, when work is said to be done means when you are applying force and the body is in motion and the body moving and the body displacing. But energy is what? Energy is the capacity to do work, or it is also called ability to do work. Means how much you are able to do, it depends on your energy. Again, when work is said to be done, we have completed. Now, what is work? What is work? Work is the product of magnitude of force, and the displacement of the body or distance moved by the body in the direction of force applied. So what is work? Work is the product of force and the displacement or the distance moved by the body in the direction of force applied. Understood? Next one. If work is done, then what happened? Energy must spend by the body. Energy must spend by the body. In that case, work and energy both are related to each other. Again, the SI unit of work is equal to joule. Actually, that is Newton into meter, or Newton meter, we are writing that is joule. So, the SI unit of work is what? Joule. Clear? But joule is the unit of energy also. Joule is the unit of energy also, and energy and work both are having equal unit, that is what? Joule. Clear? Now, definition of energy. What? Definition of energy. Energy is the ability to do work or capacity of doing work. It is what? Ability to do work, or you can say capacity of doing work. SI unit of energy also what? SI unit of energy also joule. Understood? Some other unit also we are using. Suppose anybody will ask you how much calories of food you have eaten today. It means the other unit of energy is what? Calories. Understood or not? But in CGS also, in CGS system, you can say the unit of energy is what? Calorie. And the relation between calories and joule are what? 1 calorie is equal to 4.2 joule. How much joule? 4.2 joule. Actually, the value is 4.18 something. Approximately, we are writing 4.2 joule. Understood? Or if you want to write 1 joule is equal to dex calorie, it means 0.24 calorie. 1 calorie is equal to CAL, it means calorie. 1 calorie is equal to 4.2 joule, or 1 joule is equal to 0.24 calories. Clear? Now 1 kilocalorie, KCAL, it means kilocalorie is equal to 1000 calorie. 1 kilocalorie is equal to what? 1000 calorie. Next, different form of energy is there in our water. In our home also we are using different type of energy, like electrical energy, heat energy, chemical energy, muscular energy, mechanical energy. Here we will discuss about mechanical energy. Understood? Which energy? We will discuss about mechanical energy. Mechanical energy. The two common form of mechanical energy. Two common form of mechanical energy are kinetic energy and potential energy. Two form of energy. What are that? Kinetic energy and potential energy. Let me discuss about mechanical energy first. The energy, mechanical energy, what? It is divided into two parts, kinetic energy and what? Potential energy. So the energy of a body by virtue of its motion and position or shape and size of a body is called mechanical energy. What is mechanical energy? The energy of a body by virtue of which the body possesses what? Either motion or position or shape and size changes, then it is called mechanical energy. Then mechanical energy is divided into two parts. First one is kinetic energy, second one is potential energy. One by one we will discuss. Kinetic energy depends on motion. Kinetic energy depends on motion of the body, whereas potential energy depends on position, shape and size of the body. It means potential energy depends on shape, size and what? Position of the body, whereas our kinetic energy depends on motion of the body. Understood? Next one. Kinetic energy and potential energy. This kinetic energy and potential energy together called mechanical energy. Kinetic energy and potential energy together called which energy? Mechanical energy. Understood? Now we will discuss about first form of mechanical energy, that is kinetic energy. Let us discuss about what? Kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? The energy possessed by a body by virtue or due to its motion, that is called kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? The energy possessed by a body due to its motion is called kinetic energy. Suppose a raindrops is falling from sky, possesses kinetic energy. A fast moving car possesses kinetic energy. The bullet fired from a gun possesses kinetic energy. Means all the moving object, the object which are in motion, they possesses kinetic energy. Clear? Next, kinetic energy depends on two factors. काइनेटिक एनर्जी डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ मेनी फैक्टर, टू फैक्टर, व्हाट आर दैट? द फर्स्ट वन मास ऑफ द बॉडी, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट, मास ऑफ द बॉडी, एंड सेकेंड वन वेलोसिटी ऑफ द बॉडी और स्पीड ऑफ द बॉडी, व्हाट एवर मे बी यू कैन से. सो व्हाट, काइनेटिक एनर्जी डिपेंड्स ऑन टू फैक्टर, व्हाट आर दैट, मास ऑफ द बॉडी एंड वेलोसिटी ऑफ द बॉडी. मास ऑफ द बॉडी एंड व्हाट, वेलोसिटी ऑफ द बॉडी. हाउ इट डिपेंड्स ऑन मास ऑफ द बॉडी एंड वेलोसिटी ऑफ द बॉडी, हाउ इट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट, मास ऑफ द बॉडी एंड वेलोसिटी ऑफ द बॉडी. लेट्स सी, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन मास डायरेक्टली. इट मीन्स मास इंक्रीजेस, काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑल्सो इट विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज. वेयर एज स्पीड इंक्रीजेस, काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑल्सो इंक्रीज. इट मीन्स मास, द काइनेटिक एनर्जी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू मास, काइनेटिक एनर्जी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू वेलोसिटी. क्लियर? नेक्स्ट, सपोज ए कार इज इन मोशन, ए कार इज इन मूविंग, अनदर वन ए बुलेट फायर्ड फ्रॉम ए गन इज मूविंग. यू नो द काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द कार मे बी मोर बिकॉज इट्स मास इज मोर, ए लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ मास इज देयर एज कंपेयर टू बुलेट फायर्ड फ्रॉम ए गन. अगेन ए स्कूटी इज मूविंग विथ ए स्पीड ऑफ 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर एंड अनदर स्कूटी इज 30 किलोमीटर पर आवर. फर्स्ट स्कूटी इज 20 किलोमीटर पर आवर, सेकेंड स्कूटी इज 30 किलोमीटर पर आवर. व्हिच वन इज हैविंग मोर काइनेटिक एनर्जी? मीन्स सेकेंड स्कूटी इज हैविंग मोर काइनेटिक एनर्जी. व्हाई? बिकॉज द स्पीड इज मोर एज कंपेयर टू द फर्स्ट स्कूटी. Their mass is equal. Here mass is equal. Both scooty is having same amount of mass, but they depends on. We know that kinetic energy depends on mass and velocity. If mass constant, then target to the velocity. If velocity is more, means kinetic energy is more. Understood? Another one. Two bullet. One bullet is fired from a gun. Another one is fired from another gun. First mass is 20 gram. Another mass is M1, M2 is 30 gram. Both are moving with the same speed. Suppose 20 kilometer per hour. Both are moving with the same speed. In this case, which one is having more kinetic energy? Means second one is having more kinetic energy. Why second one is having more kinetic energy? Because second bullet, the mass is more, 10 gram more than that of the first bullet. Clear? Because this are moving with the same speed, but mass is different. More mass, more kinetic energy. In this case, more speed, more kinetic energy in scooty case. No doubt. Next one. This was understood. Now the formula of kinetic energy. Now I told that kinetic energy depends on mass of the body and velocity of the body. Now according to that relation will come, kinetic energy is equal to half into mass into velocity square. It means kinetic energy, the formula of kinetic energy, to find the magnitude of kinetic energy, we have to multiply mass into velocity square divided by 2, so that you can write 1 by 2 into mass into velocity square. Here mass m is equal to mass of the body and v is equal to velocity of the body or speed of the body. Let us take one example. So understood what is the formula to find kinetic energy? Kinetic energy you can find by putting this formula, half mv square. Let's see by using this formula how we will get. Suppose one question is there, one numerical is there. A boy is moving with a speed of 20 meter per second, find his kinetic energy if mass is equal to how much? 20 kilogram. The boy mass is how much? The boy's mass is 20 kilogram and it is moving with a speed of 20 meter per second. Now what is kinetic energy? Now I told the formula of kinetic energy is what? The formula of kinetic energy is half mv square, half into mass is how much kg? The boy is 20 kg means 20 kilogram, half into 20 into velocity square. Velocity is how much? 20 meter per second. 20 square is how much? 20 into 20. Kinetic energy, the unit is what? Joule. Kinetic energy, the unit is what? Joule. So that half into 20 kg into 20 meter per second into 20 per meter per second. Collectively, I am writing joule is the unit. 2 how much ja? 2 10 ja 20. So 10 into 20 into 20. 20 into 20 is 400. 400 into 10 is how much? 4000 joule. This is the formula to find the value of kinetic energy possessed by an object or by a body. Or here one we have taken what? Boy is moving with a speed of 20 meter per second. If his mass is 20 kg, finds the kinetic energy possessed by him. Understood? Another example, let's see. Suppose a bullet is fired from a gun. A bullet is fired from a gun. If the bullet is moving with a speed, means the velocity v is 72 kilometer per hour. 72 kilometer per hour. Properly, I am writing how much? 72 kilometer per hour. And the mass is equal to 20 gram. So velocity is kilometer per hour given, but our SI unit of velocity is meter per second. So when you are converting kilometer per hour to meter per second, you are multiplying with 5/18 meter per second. When you want to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, you will multiply 5/18. 18 how much ja? 4 ja. 18 4 ja is 72. 4 5 ja 20 meter per second. We got what? 20 meter per second. Meter per second is SI unit of speed. Perfect. Next one. Mass given in gram, but kg is or kilogram is the SI unit of what? Mass. So in this case, what you will do? You will convert mass 20 gram to kg. So 20/1000 kg. You know that 1 gram is equal to 1/1000 kg. So 20 gram is equal to 20/1000. 0, 0, 2, 1, 2, 5, 2, 0. Means 1/50 kg. Understood? Now mass got, velocity got, you can find kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is equal to half into mass into velocity square. Half into mass how much? 1/50 into 20 meter per 20 into 20 meter per second. Or I am writing direct joule. Now 2 decks are 2 10 ja. 10 decks are 10 5 ja. 5 decks are 5 4 ja 20. Now the answer is 4 joule is the right answer. 4 joule is the right answer. This is all about your kinetic energy. So kinetic energy depends on mass of the body and velocity of the body. And how it depends? It depends what? Directly to the mass of the body, and it depends directly to the square of velocity of the body. Understood? So that we are writing the formula kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Understood? Next class we will discuss about potential energy, and also we will discuss the numericals of potential energy, how we will find. Understood? Today up to this much. If you have enjoyed the class, then subscribe it, like it, and share with your friends. Understood? Up to this much today. Clear? Stay in home, stay safe. You know that what is the crisis. Understood or not? In Balangir, the situation day by day, it is what? Critical. So that stay in home and stay at home and stay alive and stay safe. Understood? Goodbye.